Hey, good morning, dude. Good morning, dude. Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy. It's your first vet appointment. You ready? You're not scared, right?
No, you can't. No.
No, good morning. Hello. Good morning. You can't be over here. You can't be over here. You gotta sit over here, buddy. Let's go to the vet.
What are you doing over there, dude?
Come on, buddy.
I got your leash. Check it out. Check it out, guys. Look at this. Dude. You can be a brave little doggo?
Yeah. Animal hospital. Okay, we'll burn up there. Sir? Sir, can you tell dude it's gonna be okay? Sir?
See what you weigh, dude.
You'll be a big boy.
2 minutes in, they already had a thermometer up her butt. Sorry, dude. Would you say that was rough?
Hey, dude, you did so good. You're all done, buddy. You're all done.
All right, well, dude is eating his breakfast. I'm gonna eat mine. I got myself a chicken biscuit from Chick-fil-A, a large fruit cup. You know, I'm not a huge fan of blueberries. Like, I love blueberry-flavored things. I love them in my smoothie, but, like, actual blueberries, not really for me. I got this egg white chicken thing that Mona always gets. I have never gotten. Wow. That's actually really good. Getting ourselves one fish oil. Eat your food. You gotta go up and be big and strong so you can deadlift more than me. All right, we have your first medicine for your heartworms and fleas. Will you give me a good boy and take this?
Come on. It's okay. It's okay. Come on. I know it smells. Come on.
I have an idea.
Look what Uncle Christian has.
You wanna try some peanut butter?
Put this in the peanut butter.
Oh!
Ha ha, I am tricking the dog.
Good morning, Mona.
Good morning.
What's the update on the launch we had on Friday?
It went great. Are you asking about shipping?
Yeah, what's the problem?
I just got off the phone with USPS. They said we can't schedule shipments.
Says who?
I was like, he's like, you have to pay for that. And I was like, I did. And he's like, oh, okay.
Yes, it's $20 online. We did this in Virginia. We had this problem in Virginia where they just wouldn't show up.
Yeah, but they didn't show up at all. And they're saying that no one was here. I was like, no, I was here until you guys were closed on Saturday.
So on Saturday we were supposed to come when?
At 1.
And they never came.
And then they never came. And then so I called this morning and they're like, oh yeah, we can't do that because it'll come whenever we come. And I was like, but I scheduled it for a reason, paid for it for a reason.
So these are all of the packages that were supposed to go out Saturday. They're going out today. Sorry for the little bit of delay, but thank you guys for snagging up a bomber. I hope you love them.
Yeah, make some bags, some better bags you can put them in.
Yeah, that'd be great. So I've been using, like you said, the trash bags before. So they have like, I guess like durable, like breathable bags.
You worked out and you said, oh, so you know.
Yeah. Better late than never, but never late is better. So the post office guy said that he was gonna start bringing us as many of these as we need. These are from the post office themselves. They're very like tough bags. We can put all of the orders in and then they'll just keep, you know, bringing us new ones as we need them. And then they have holes on here, so they'll give us like a rack so we can put these on to put the orders, which is very nice because currently we use trash bags. It's like our only method, or we use the boxes. Some people talk down, they're like, oh my God, you put the orders in trash bags, Max? Like, dude, do something better. It's like, what? Why does it matter? What? Today is the day, Christian.
I was like picking my teeth.
That's fine, man. We're natural over here. Yeah. Today is the day. You know what today is?
What?
It's the
new program.
New program. We got a new dog. We got a new life in Texas. We're getting back on our strength. Today is day one of Mr. Brett Gibbs' new strength program. We have like military press, which we've never really done. Still using like the RPE scale. Christian's on a new program. He's actually doing like calves like 4 times a week, like an idiot. I'm telling you, please, can you like, you need to measure and then like, and like,
well, we did measure.
And then like, and then 4 weeks, I want you to, or no, like 4 months.
Yeah, like
come
4
back
months,
and tell me they're the same size.
Right before I do summer shredding, I'll do it.
They're gonna be the same size.
Longer than 4 months. I probably need
They're gonna be the same size.
They might be, no.
They're gonna be the exact same size.
I mean, pause reps this time though.
What the hell? Pause. So first up, we have tempo bench. We haven't done this in a very, very long time. We have a 4 second down. And now if you do this by yourself, you don't have someone to count it off like Christian does, you're gonna like go a lot faster. The first thing I did, it was like, I'm supposed to do 4. I was like, 1, 2, 3, 4. Pause, go up. You have to do a set of 5. It's only 210 pounds my top set. We're just easing back into it, but Christian's gonna count off.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, three, four. Two, three, four. Two more. Four. Two, three, four.
Oh, man! Oh, God! Don't worry, guys. Today, this programmer didn't hit 315 for like a double or triple. Believe.
So today we are supposed to get up to a maximum set of 10. We're working with 115 pounds. And then after the set of 10, I wait 10 seconds and do sets of four, wait 10 seconds and keep doing sets of four until I can't anymore. I don't know how many I'm gonna get because this is such a hard exercise. I haven't done standing military press in a long time, and if you have not done standing strict overhead military press with a barbell, it is by far the hardest exercise. You think like trying to get to like a 600 pound deadlift is hard? No. Overhead press is a hard exercise. So if you were wondering, this is an off-season program that we're running. We have no competition in mind right now. When I do compete again, and I definitely will in 2019, I want to hit some substantial numbers. So with the last competition, we hit milestones for lifting. A 500 pound squat or over 500. 315 bench, we've been chasing forever. And then a deadlift PR, we take where we can get it. The next milestone would be like 550 squat, 350 or 365 bench, which is probably a far ways away. And then the next realistic milestone for deadlift would be like 650 or 675, which is at seven plates, which I think is definitely obtainable maybe in the next like 6 months or so once we're back on track. And with everyone starting to probably diet down in the next month or two, I might get a little tempted to try to get shredded, dude. But you guys in the comments gotta keep me motivated and be like, Max, dude, stay pudgy, just focus on feeding dude and making him a big strong boy, and then you just keep building your powerlifting numbers up. Don't worry about the abs. You don't need girls anymore because you have a doggo, and that is all that matters. So,
dude.
Oh. You been sleeping the whole time?
No, I took him out.
Hey, dude.
He was,
I was getting shredded over there. You just been snoozing?
No, oh. He went crazy for a little bit.
Did he miss me?
Yeah.
Woo! It's the first thing that's ever missed me.
So we just got to Christian's parents. We're gonna introduce dude to Knox. Knox is a little more rambunctious than Nala.
Yeah, with little babies. Yeah, Knox isn't.
Nala already like paws at him and he like flies across the room and he freaks out, but two huskies, one golden doodle. Gone sexual. Prank in the hood. Here we go.
Yeah.
Be gentle.
Be gentle.
You gotta teach dude how to woof. Dinner, what do we got, dude?
Some beef and chicken and shrimp skewers. And white rice.
You know, as much as I love Chipotle and stuff, nothing beats a nice home-cooked meal. I mean, not like if you and I cooked because we can't make stuff like this. Actually, Heidi, you could probably make stuff like this, right?
We bought this from HEB yesterday.
I literally made that, but not as good. Yesterday.
Well, Mama can,
this
like,
looks delicious. So I've lived in Texas for 19 days and I have yet to actually go get groceries. I've been eating out every meal and I want to start cooking more. I gotta be home more. I can't be leaving dude in the crate. It just breaks my little heart. And now Walmart is across the street and I want to go to Walmart, but everyone's like, Max, gotta go to HEB, man. So this is HEB, as you see, at 123, Mr. Maxi. Yeah, apparently this is a good grocery store. So we're gonna try it out. Gonna get some apples, gonna get some bananas, gonna get some Frosty Paws for dude. Gonna get some stuff. Let's try this out. And they actually have a gas station here, which is great in Northern Virginia. They don't have this. Reminds me of Kroger back in the day because you get points for getting groceries and then you get cheaper gas. You're gonna want that. Okay, first things first, besides being the realist, these Granny Smith apples, which are the best apples, keep that in mind. These look very good. Nice green color. Nice shape. Okay, HEB, I see you. Had to get some peanut butter to put in Dude's Kong so he can just be like, decided to go with the all natty Jif creamy because dude is not gonna like crunch peanut butter because crunch peanut butter sucks. Creamy, low sodium, natural. I need some mustard. I'm team French's on mustard. Like, I'm team Heinz on ketchup, never Hunt's. If you like Hunt's ketchup, you need to get out of here, but not Heinz mustard. We're team French's on mustard. Check this stuff out, guys. Look at this. Crustless bread. That is the dumbest thing I've ever heard. You wanna know who probably likes this stuff? Freaks who like avocado. Pasta, we're going with protein plus. I really like this one. I used to, back in the day, get nothing but these like whole grain ones, but honestly, they just don't taste that good to me. And like, for example, with the bread, like certain things I'll go with whole wheat options. This says like no high fructose corn syrup, which are, you know, if I have the option to get those things, I do. But if certain things don't taste good, I just don't. Like, there's a time in my life where I ate nothing but like whole grain everything. I wouldn't touch white rice, white pasta, anything that had like enriched flour. I'd be like, not up in here. And it just like, I was like almost suffering. Like, I didn't enjoy it. I wasn't like liking my foods. I wasn't enjoying my diet. And I think it's just not that big of a deal. Some people aren't going to agree with me, but I did the whole like, you know, whole grain everything, no enriched, for like over a year. I wasn't any stronger. My physique wasn't any better. I didn't feel any healthier or better. My skin wasn't any better. So just don't overstress it that much, or do. You know, at the end of the day, you can do whatever the oh my gosh, check this stuff out. Honey Bun Cereal, official Hostess. We got to try it. I am the world's biggest chocolate milk fan. We're gonna go with the sugar-free version. Some people are like, Max, the sugar-free version is probably worse for you than if you just get the full sugar version. Max, diet sodas are worse than you than regular sodas. But just don't, then don't get it, all right? Then just don't get it. Definitely need a big bag of fruit. Guys, what in the hell is rhubarb? I have never in my entire 29 years on this planet heard of rhubarb fruit. You know what? Let's try it out. If you have ever listened to one thing on this channel, listen to this. Never, ever get broccoli cutlets. Never get broccoli cutlets. You ever get broccoli and you're like, what the heck? Half of them are these little stupid things? That's because you got cutlets. Dude, you want to get florets. 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 Oh my God, here it is, guys. Frosty paws. If you have never gotten your dog these, go to the store and get, don't get dogsters. Look at these. These are, what, would you trust that dog? No. You trust this little guy. Look how happy he is. Frosty paws, dogs love, you know, we're gonna get two. Cause dude just is gonna love these. So it turns out I was wrong, and HB does not have a point system. Well, that's annoying, because I really, really like point systems. I think Walmart's better, guys. Like, there's no way that I could have gotten this stuff for cheaper HEB. There's no way. Team Walmart! Team Walmart! So it's a little later in the evening and I went to work out and no one could watch dude, so I put him in the crate, and this is still one thing that is I'm getting used to, is having to like leave him alone. And just hearing him cry is just like actually like makes me sad. Hey buddy, I'm sorry, dude. Hey buddy, I'm back. Hey man. Hey buddy, come here. Hey, I'm sorry. I know. Hey. I know, I'm back. I know, I don't ever want to leave you. I read a lot online that like, you can't all, like they need to be in their crate sometimes. Like obviously when I go away, but like I could have taken him to the gym for the front, but I want him to be able to be by himself and, you know, be an independent little doggo. So at least that's what I've read. Like, you know, you can't be with him 24/7. So as much as I want to, man, you've been such a good boy. So dude has not been eating all of his food. So I'm gonna try to put in a little water, kind of wet it up, kind of trick him, maybe see if he likes that. Dude, I want you to get bigger and strong, so you gotta eat all your food, man. Come on, buddy. Here you go. He won't eat the food. I even gave him a non-wet option. Dude, eat the food, Tina. All right, what if I give you dessert, because this has calories in it. I still would rather you eat this than nothing. Do you want a Frosty Paw? Oh, you like that, dude? Okay, well, you know, calories are calories, I guess. So today's video was pretty much all dude again, and he's just been consuming my life. You know, being a new dad is just like a whole new world to me. And, you know, I want to make cool montages and stuff and cool edits and lots of sick angles. But right now, my life is just this little guy.
So I hope you guys don't mind tons of the video being about him. We're gonna try to balance it as we learn to balance life, but just having him for like, hey, what are you? Just having him for like 4 days now, I'm in love with this little guy. And I think it's the best decision that I've ever made. And he's just my best bud. And like, I'm really glad I got him. And I'm glad that like, you know, he was the last one and he's perfect. And I can't wait till he's so big and I'm learning every single day. I'm gonna be showing you guys what I'm learning. You know, I'm new to this whole dog thing and it's gonna get better each day. Each week he's gonna get bigger and we're just gonna document everything and you're just gonna be the best dog ever in the world, aren't you? And he pooped tonight outside. Last night he pooped right here. When I shower, he gets super scared and he just like sits and like paws at the shower. And then last night he pooped. And I take him out for like 30 minutes before. But tonight he pooped outside. Very good boy. So thank you guys for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Leave some comments down below of what kind of videos you want me to make. Or just keep documenting, dude. See you later. Smash the thumbs up button. Goodbye. 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 Yes. Oh.